David Botstein is a force of nature.
Well, with David, you never, never have to wait for his opinion.
He's not shy about what he thinks.
David is very boisterous and energetic and enthusiastic.
And when David is an enthusiastic supporter, things happen.
I became interested in science relatively early in life.
He was always interested in understanding fundamentally how things worked.
One of David's huge impacts in the field was a series of studies to understand how genes interact with each other.
Nobody knew how any of that actually worked at the molecular level. And what we did was we provided a genetic way of identifying interactions between these different pieces so that we could get some idea of how it worked. Later, it turned out that some of the technology which we developed in the yeast system, where we could check everything, could be applied also to human cancers.
The most productive idea to come from David is the idea of nucleotide polymorphism.
These signposts, these polymorphisms as they're called, they were also the backbone on which the human genome sequence was first assembled.
Prior to that, there was no such thing as genomics, but this tool transformed everything.
As a result of David's genetic studies on physical mapping of genomes, there was a proposal to sequence the entire human genome. At a critical meeting in the symposium at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory in 1986, Jim Watson brought a number of very prominent scientists together to discuss this, including David Botstein. But as a result of that meeting, David was asked to be on a committee.
David and I were members of the National Research Council's study to determine the feasibility of sequencing the Human Genome Project.
Well, the Human Genome Project, of course, was one of the greatest scientific accomplishments in the history of science, not just in the life sciences, but of all of sciences.
I suspect there are very few working biological and biomedical scientists who are not using DNA sequencing in some way to inform the questions they're asking about the natural world.
David Botstein is one of the great characters in science. He's an extraordinarily talented investigator and experimentalist. But I think one of the things that I admire the most about him is he is one of the most enthusiastic teachers of science that I know.
In his role as a teacher, he thought very carefully about what's wrong with traditional ways of doing things.
He has had a big impact from his days when he was a professor at MIT to teaching courses at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, to the development of a whole new program at Genentech, and most interestingly, the development of an education program at Princeton University of integrative sciences.
I recently was writing a grant application where one of the questions was, you had to state how you could differentiate yourself from your mentor. And instead, I ended up writing about how I hope that I'm still like David in a lot of respects, because I hope I bring that same rigor of thinking and engagement with students to my own mentoring relationships.
The enthusiasm, the idealism, the boundless energy, the imagination, the intensity of his engagement and his achievement is a source of real pride.
I think that if you were going to name, top five biologists by intelligence, David would be on that list for sure.
David is one of the greatest geneticists of the 20th century.